Speaker, my dear colleagues, I'm Abubakar Chika Adamu. I represent Shurora Female Constituency. Mr. Speaker, I'm from Niger State. Mr. Speaker, my dear colleagues, the increase in the minimum wage is a welcome development. But however, Mr. Speaker, the 27,000 agreed by the system for me is very, very inadequate. Mr. Speaker, people, I am not an economist. But when we follow the trend, I follow the trend of economy because I have interest. Mr. Speaker, when you look at before the last minimum wage, each and every worker in Nigeria, if you are going to put the salary he was earning vis-a-vis that is the 18,000, then it was equal to about $150. What is $150 today? $150 today is nearly about 49,000 naira. And the cost of life, the inflation that has eaten the economy within that period is about 116%. Now, Mr. Speaker, we are now giving them 27,000 naira. And by this year, Mr. Speaker, if we look at the economic indices, there's likely going to be increase in the fuel price. There's going to be likely increase in the cost of energy. The federal government is mulling to increase tax. Mr. Speaker, this money is grossly inadequate. Why do I have to spend? Mr. Speaker, I started work in my life as a clerical officer. I know what it takes to be an officer at the lower level. This money, Mr. Speaker, that is said we cannot review or it will not be reviewed until in the next 5 years, I think this is wrong. Mr. Speaker, we have to check this system. We have to check that 5 years. I don't agree that we will not review this thing until in the next 5 years. Let's look at it in the next 1 year or in the next 2 years at the most. Because I am sure by the economic indices we have on the ground, this money will no longer be called money by the end of this year. So, Mr. Speaker, that 5 years, I appeal to my colleagues when we go out to the committees, this we should look again. Mr. Speaker, too, I heard Mr. President saying that this increase is for only those who are earning below 30,000 naira. Mr. Speaker, those who are earning above are also going to the same market. And we should have seniority in public service. I have stayed, I have gone to school, I have worked for a long period of time, and you have increased salary and saying you will negotiate with me is not practical. Mr. Speaker, I wish that the executive submitted this salary with the table of increase so that we will know where this salary is going. We should have seen the percentage increase at each level. That will help us or will guide us in taking decision. But I wish this House, Mr. Speaker, should write before the public hearing so that we can see the table they wanted to adopt in terms of increase in this salary. Why we did not? Mr. Speaker, we are living the same trouble that will now emerge by the most senior officers in the public service, because even if I'm a senior officer, I will not agree. You increase 30,000 to my next junior level, I may be in level 6 and in that 30,000, and you have increased that amount, which is 27,000 as a minimum wage, to somebody who will meet me as a level 6 officer and he's a level 3 officer. I will not agree with that. So for us to solve the problem, we need to see the table of the increment at the various grade levels. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Thank you, my dear colleagues.